how a date night went really bad. Alright, so back in like September, me and my girlfriend both working out. Like I was working upwards to like 40 hours a week and she was working like 30, 35. And so like we really didn't have enough time to hang out. And so this one Friday night, like I was working a short shift. And so my cousin works with me, so I hit him up. I'm like, hey, like, can you do me a solid? Like, can you cover half of my shift? You know, like I'll go in for 3 hours and like you work the last three. So he comes in like around 7, you know, and he's like, hey, like, I got you. And so I clock out, I head home, and I'm like, alright, I get ready. You know, I put on my nice clothes and I go. I get my girlfriend, like, we go out, right? We go to the movies and we go, we enjoy the movie, the night out, and she's like, oh, my grandma wants us to come over for dinner. I was like, yeah, man, like, let's go, you know? And during this night, like, it was raining, like quite like a day like this, but like at night. And so we started driving in a short car ride, you know. And so I didn't really bother to put a seatbelt on. I was like, whatever, like, it's like basically down the street, you know, my stupid ass. And so I ended up regretting this because, like, we go down this dark street, like, there was no lights on. It was, like, pitch black, and, like, there was a dip there. And since it was raining, like, it was completely covered in water. So we didn't realize there was a dip until, like, right when we crossed over it. And so we went over, like, it sent me flying up in the air, and, like, I hit my head. And then she had, like, a glass mason jar where she has, like, coins in. And so that flew out. And like it landed right under me, and so when I came back down, it completely shattered on like my ass. So I was just like, whoa, fuck. And so I'm like, ah, oh, like I stand up, like in the car, she stops the car, and she's like, yo, okay? I was like, yeah, like I brush away the glass, and then I'm like, I think I'm fine, and like it just feels like I got dead, like, you know? I was like, oh, like I'm chilling, there's no hole in my pants. And then all of a sudden, like, my butt starts twitching, you know, like, oh. And then it just feels wet, and I reach over, and I'm like, oh, there's nothing, though, and I go again, it's just completely covered in blood, and I'm like, yo, like, I'm fucking bleeding. And she's like, what do I do? I was like, dude, I'm like, what do I do? Like, she's like, oh, just get in the bag, and so I jump in the bag, and she's like, what do I do? And I was like, let me call my mom. I was like, hey, mom, like, we got in an accident, like, what do I do? And she's like, what kind of accident? I was like, well, I'm kind of bleeding. And she's like, well, go to the hospital. I was like, okay, like, I'll tell you what happened over there. And so my girl's like, what do I do? I was like, dude, I'm like, just drive. And she's like, where are we going? I was like, the hospital. She's like, which one? I was like, bro, like, I'm like, just show me. So we get there, and my parents beat us there, you know, and she already let the hospital know, like, oh, we were coming and then an accident happened. So they thought I got stabbed, you know? So they opened it, and like, they're checking, like, my shirt and everything. They're like, where's the stab wound? And I'm like, I didn't get stabbed. I'm like, where's the wound? I'm like, it's on my ass. They're like, what do you mean? I was like, well, like, the glass on the front seat? I was like, I landed on that. And so they're like, what the heck? And so they come and they cut the leg of my pants, you know, and they see this huge gash, like, my butt cheek, my left butt cheek, you know? And they're like, oh, shit. Like, that's exactly what the nurse is. They're like, oh, shit. They're like, can you get up? I was like, nope. And so like then I like pull my legs a bit, and then like I slowly had to lean over and get, and like they slowly like carried me in. And so I get into the ER, right? And so then the doctor's in there with the nurse, and like he just tells the nurse to like, hey, like just clean it up, you know, apply pressure, stop the bleeding, and then I'll just come back and sew it back together, you know? Easy, right? And so I thought like, it'll go quick, right? You know, it'll be like I'll be in and out in like an hour. And so like this dude's like just putting a bunch of pressure on my butt. I'm like, dude, like, it's getting hella comfortable. And then like, he couldn't stop the bleeding. So he calls another nurse, and now there's two nurses just like touching my butt. I'm like, I don't like this, you know? Like, I just want to go home. And like, those two nurses couldn't stop us. So they hit up another doctor, and like, hey, like the doctor, not the doctor, the blood won't stop. And so the doctor comes and like, he sees and like, they keep applying more pressure. And then he brings another doctor. So now there's two doctors and two nurses, like trying to stop the bleeding. And I'm like, yo, like what the hell? And so they finally, like, they call another doctor and they say, like, all right, like, let's go get some x-rays. And I'm like, oh, like, yeah, like, after 2 hours of bleeding, like, go get x-rays, you know? So we go get x-rays and they find out that, like, it completely cut a vein in half, like, in my rear, you know? And so they're like, all right, we need to prepare you for surgery. And so they said, like, if it's bad, like, they say usually when they prepare people for surgery, they stay a night and they do it the next day. So I was like, oh, like, I'm gonna stay a night, you know? And then I started to freak out because they're like, alright, never mind, like we're calling up the surgeons, like you need to get surgery now. And I'm like, what the hell? I'm like, really? They're like, yeah, so they get me ready, you know, like they call up the surgeons, they get there, they're like carrying me to the room, You know, and like my girlfriend's like sobbing her eyes out, you know, she's like, oh, like I can't believe this happened. And like my mom's like freaking out. And like I just look over to my dad and like he just started laughing his ass off. He's like, how does that shit happen? Like you're so stupid. And so like everything goes well, like I go to surgery, I wake up the next day and I'm like, bro, like I should have just stayed at work. Yeah, it was just very nice.